everybody. Hi, everyone in Chicago Land. I'm Miss Mia.
And I'm Ransom.
And we're here with one of my favorite directors in the whole world, Jim Jarmusch. Yay! Hi.
Hooray. Hey, yay. Hey,
welcome to Chicago.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here, I think.
Yeah, you are. Welcome to Chicago.
Thank you, in a way.
So, even though...
I love your movies.
Rats. I love rats.
All right.
Don't get too close, though, rats.
Okay.
All right, we've got something in common then. So in addition to being a fabulous director and a musician and a big music fan, I know that you have a big appreciation for the music world and you like to cast musicians in some of your movies.
Yes, I have a lot of musician friends and a lot of them have appeared in my films and a lot of them are great actors.
So can we kind of let the kids know at home why you pick these musicians in particular and what if they weren't actors already, what you saw in them that you thought would be good to direct?
Well, because they're crazy characters and they're interesting people and, you know, because artists often can do more than one thing and sometimes great musical performers become great actors.
That's... Wow. See that, kids? You can do more than one. You can do anything you want.
So, Elvis.
Yeah, like Elvis. Do you wish you would have directed him?
Yeah, like Elvis, yeah. and James Brown, too. And James?
Oh, he's great. Great to Come into America. The one with Rocky Five.
That was Rocky Four.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah, I didn't see that.
You didn't direct that one, though.
No, Ratso, I didn't. If I had, I would have got paid a lot, and I wouldn't be here.
Okay, so let's talk about some of the musicians that you directed. Let's start with Tom Waits. He's one of my favorites. What did you like about working with him?
Tom Waits, well, he's just like a very unusual imagination. He has a great imagination. And he's also very talented. He makes sculptures, and he's a musician and an actor and all kinds of things. And he just has a lot of wild ideas, interesting ideas.
And now we're going to dance to Tom Waits.
Yay!
Yay!
No.
Let's move on to Screamin' Jay Hawkins. What was it like working with him?
Screamin' Jay Hawkins. Well, he's sort of like my uncle in a way. He almost seemed like part of my family. I love him so much. And
I have a crazy uncle too.
You do? Well, he was my crazy uncle, Screamin' Jay Hawkins.
Wow.
And I was so happy to have him, to get to work with him and use his music. Another crazy character.
Yeah. He's very handsome.
Especially in that suit he wore in that movie Mystery Train.
Right, red suit, yeah.
And speaking of...
He likes rats, too, I think.
Awesome!
Rats like him.
And now, we're all gonna go to the Chicago studio and dance to Screamin' Jay Hawkins!
Ooh, Screamin' Jay Hawkins!
See? Must be! Eating a wax feather sandwich in the middle of 1900 and yesterday. Shut your mouth. What you say? There's a sack hanging in your head with your brains in it. Eating stuffed chop suey, corroded biscuits, and bat knee soup in a gas mask.
Like working with Joe Strummer, my gosh.
Yeah, Joe Strummer, who unfortunately he died last year, so we send respect out always to Joe Strummer, who was one of the most generous and, I don't know, just like so enthusiastic a person. Another person who did many things, music and acting and creating artwork for records and all kinds of things, producing other groups and a great spirit, a wonderful person. That's right, Rat. So he will.
Absolutely.
He will always be. So long live Joe Strummer.
Yeah, yeah. And now we're going to go to the Chicago Studio Central and dance to the amazing, amazing Joe Strummer.
And the Clash.
And the Clash.
Shake it to the top. The shaking through his collar.
And what was it like working with RZA? He seems like a real cool cat.
The RZA, he's got the funky fresh fly flavor from New York City, from Staten Island, otherwise known by the Wu-Tang as Shaolin.
Right. You've got your verbiage down pat with the RZA in mind.
The RZA.
Hey, do you know if Liza Minnelli was in Wu-Tang, she'd be called the RZA?
Ooh, ouch.
Things from stalks and Clark wallabies. African killer bees, black watch. On your radio, blowing out your watch. From Park Hill, the house on Haunted Hill. Every time you walk by, your back hit a chill. Les Bell, who wants to talk about skill. I spit like a semi-automatic to the grill. Elbow grease and elbow room. Baby, play me, baby, fall down, go boom. Party people gather round, count down to apocalypse. I'm the kid with the golden arms. And I'm the hot nick. Pass the blunt. My don't front, you had it for a minute, but it seemed like a month. Now I'm choking, smoking, hoping I don't croaking from overdosing, dosing. Hey kid,
watch me after
when the mouth got you open, hope let's ride. Can't stand that floss too much. Can't stand Bentleys, they cost too much. Can't wanna get up, and can't get touched. Can't wanna stick up, and can't get stuck. I'm the one that calls you bluff when your boy try to act tough. Remember what old Dirty said, I'll listen.
Back and forth.
Styles extremist, forehead beamers run wild as the kid with the gold cup. Steps out like what? Was popping in yachts, gold ball glassing, say say chocolate saute. Rich Calamox rock those all day, 1960s, them goldie. That fight, motherfucker, don't hold me. The world's greatest, Las Vegas paid his rock. Skin painted on my face, look ageless, perfect combos. Ghost bang out condos, jet from Homo, X, D, Bongos, Bankos, Bankos, and Plankos. Change those, bang those, same old, same old.
So what was it like working with John Laurie? I think it's been a while since you directed him, but he's another neat musician you worked with.
Yeah, John Laurie, we go way back. We've been friends for years and years, and he is also a filmmaker and made some great films and a great TV show called Fishing with John.
I'm assuming he was fishing in it.
Yes, it's a show where different people go fishing with John. Tom Waits in one episode, Willem Dafoe, myself, Dennis Hopper. And
Laurie has a good lure. Good lure, get it? Lure.
Better jokes than you have too, I think.
We could.
All right, now we're gonna check out John Lurie's non-fishing band. They're called the Lounge Lizards.
Dance to this one.
My life has been good to me, and all the animals on the farm went, yeah. five hoes.
Ho, 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 ho.
He walked up onto the hill, up onto the grassy knoll where President Kennedy was shot, and he could see off yonder, off in the distance, that the yak who was tied to a chain to a tree was acting strange. The yak was moving its head from side to side. The yak was making horrifying noises. The yak was going, rah, 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 rah. And the farmer cut close to me and said, what's wrong? What's wrong? What could be wrong with the yak? And the yak said, I'm sick, you stupid farmer! I'm burning up with fever! So the yak was acting terrifying, and the farmer moved closely to the yak because he was afraid of the yak, because the yak had bit him one time. And so he moved up closely and he put his hand on the yak's forehead, and the yak was going, rah, rah, rah. And he could feel that the yak was burning up with fever, and it terrified the man. So he rushed down the hill. He rushed down the hill past all the animals, who all looked nervous about the situation that was happening. And first came up to the porch, and he burst into the kitchen, and he said to his wife, who was beautiful and fair, he said, the yak is sick! The yak is sick! The yak is burning up with fever! The yak is sick! Ah! And his wife, as always, put her hands on his shoulder and said, calm down, be calm, just be calm. The yak is sick. The yak has a fever. Just feed the yak. Give the yak some toast. Give the yak some toast. Give the yak some here. Give some of this oatmeal here, and give it some raisinettes and some pork chops from last night. And she so laden the man there with food that he could not see where he was going. But he knew the path, and he walked out the kitchen door backwards.
Are there any other musicians that I'm kind of missing on your top list of people?
But that have inspired you and your creativity?
Yeah, many, many musicians. Unfortunately, some aren't here anymore, you know, like Bob Marley and John Lee Hooker or John Lennon or many great musicians. It would have been so much fun to work with.
Were you friends with Klaus Nomi? I saw a picture of you together.
Yes, I was friends with Klaus Nomi.
Yeah, we saw a cool picture of you. Not old, it's just cool. We saw a cool picture of you guys together. He was remarkable.
He dances with my Chicago a lot.
We do. He's one of our, we circulate him a lot. He's neat.
Excellent. Klaus Nomi. Again, he, long live Klaus Nomi.
Yeah. Musicians are creative kids that are watching?
Yes, you know, you should always protect your imagination. Your imagination is the most important, one of the most important things you have, and you should celebrate it, and you should make drawings or make films or dance or act or anything that inspires you, and you should learn about books and movies, and you should have your parents read to you things like Through the Looking Glass,
yeah.
Or Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah.
And when you're old enough to read, you'll find amazing magical worlds inside of books and also inside movies and pieces of music. So remember, always your imagination is very important, and don't let anyone take it away from you, ever.
That's a great note. Thank you so much. It was so nice having you on our show. We really appreciate it. We know you're busy here running around, so thanks for taking time.
Well, I'm happy to have been here, and Chicka Go Go rules.
Woo, and so do you. Yay! Bye, everyone.
Yay,
bye.
Yay for Ratso.
Miss Mia?
Yes, Ratso.